In today's video, I'm going to show you how to set up picture-in-picture multi-camera mode using Moblin for iPhone. If you've never used picture-in-picture before or multi-cam mode, it lets you do things like having your front and back cameras on the same scene, which is great for walking, hiking, or bike streams so your viewers can see you and a little bit of your surroundings. So make sure you've downloaded the latest version of Moblin for your iPhone. I've already done this, so I'm going to open a fresh copy. So firstly, we're going to unlock some features that are hidden by default. You can do that by going into the settings, scroll to the very bottom of the list, and show all settings. For this demo, so you can see a little bit of everything I'm doing, I'm going to change the screen orientation to portrait, which you can find in the quick button menu along the right hand side. Usually it's either at the top or the very bottom. So in this case, since we're in landscape mode, it's at the very top, so I'm going to select portrait. Now you can physically rotate the whole phone, and it just makes it a little bit easier to be able to see all the menu items. Currently on the front camera, I've turned the camera off for now. We're going to go into the settings, going to go into scenes, and then widgets, where you'll see there's a create button. Go into my widget, and change the name to front wide. This will obviously be the front wide camera. Click done or go back. Now for the type, video source. At the moment it says screen capture. We're going to change that to front wide to match the name of the widget. There are some other things, corner radius, if you want to have a border, face tracking enabled. Play around with these in your own time and then let me know how it goes. I'm going to go back to scenes where we currently have front wide. I'm going to create another one. We're going to go into my widget, change the name to back wide. For the type, video source. For the video source, I'll select back wide. Same thing with the corner radius, rotation, mirror, etc. We're going to go back. Now we have our existing scenes, which is the back camera, the front camera. Now we can add our new widgets to these, and I'll show you how. Tap on the back camera. So you'll see the name for the scene is called back, and video source name is currently set to back wide dual auto. You'll notice there's some other settings, for example, rotation, override video stabilization. If you enable that, that's where you can turn the stabilization off. Standard, cinematic, cinematic extended. For widgets, I'm going to select add. And since this is currently the back camera, we want the front wide widget. Close out of our settings, select back. The next thing we could do is we could reposition our new widget. So we'll go back into scenes, scenes, back, then scroll to the bottom where front wide is. And you'll notice there that we have position, one which is for the X position and one which is for the Y. X meaning left or right, and Y position up and down. You can also change the size. Change the width and the height. And then if you did want to jump straight to the widget section, you can from here. So you could change it to perhaps one of these other options for video source. I'm going to go back, and then we're going to go back again. Next thing, we have the numeric input. So let's say you're very particular about the positioning, then you can do that here. But if you're fine with just the sliders, you have that option as well. So that's really nice, because I'm a bit of both, where I want to quickly move it to maybe the right hand side, then we have that option with the numeric input. We'll enter some very specific things for the front wide camera. Now, rather than having to copy each one of these positions for the other scene, what you could do is we'll go right back to scenes. You could swipe left on a scene and then duplicate both the scene and the widgets. We've got a copy there now, and you'll notice we have our widget with the same positioning and size details. Everything is the same. So we're just going to swipe to delete. To turn off a widget, there is a quick button from the right hand side. Turn on or off any widgets. So I'll just try and find it here. So we could turn off the front wide camera where it's just the back camera. Just find something a little bit nicer for you guys to look at. There's my desktop. Well, if we want to re-enable the front wide widget, then we can. Be mindful of what effect having the widgets will have on your phone. You might start having issues because all these multiple cameras running at the same time, which could increase odds of your phone overheating, app crashes, and other issues. So one thing you can do is to periodically turn off the widgets. That way it's just going to ease the load on your phone. Maybe if it's starting to overheat, you could take off the case. Be very careful. Now if it's still playing up, you might have to go with a two phone setup. So that's something that I definitely talk about in this video right over here.